Hello, 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 hello. Welcome back, beautiful multi-dimensional beings, lightworkers, starseeds incarnated, or hello if you're new, and welcome to today's channeled message and reading for you, beautiful, beautiful souls. So exciting. We're gonna get straight into it, and I'm excited about this one because honestly, you guys, it's crazy, like doing these readings and everything for the collective. It's like we're all kind of going through these processes together, and it has been a ride recently, okay? It's been a ride recently, but you guys, today's message is really exciting and more on the note of the fact that there seems to be like such a clarification, a clarity being integrated into you, such a kind of sense of alignment, realignment. You guys have actually been undergoing, I keep hearing it as procedure. You've been undergoing a procedure. Like this is some type of energetic procedure that your guides have been undertaking with you. So guiding you to certain things, like they have been realigning your auric field, your chakras, your energy, and almost activating this reawakening of Kundalini life force energy. So life force energy has been culminating and cultivated within you through these past phases or recent past, where you have been doing all of that clearing and in very much the opposite energy maybe to life force. This has been more of a rest period and going into the subconscious and things like that, really integrating and adjusting to the shift that you've been going through. And throughout this particular shift recently, you guys are cultivated or have cultivated now this kind of releasing of life force energy that is moving through you as you stabilized into this new frequency or new timeline. And you know, you have always been shifting. We always talk about this, always shifting, but you've been through quite a big energetic clear out and shift recently. And this has been very, very major and impactful. And there are some effects coming from this, because this shift that you've undergone recently is almost highlighting, emphasizing, and making it prominent to you certain experiences, realizations, and revelations about you, your multidimensional nature, and your perception and your being, right? The perception that you have of reality, the being that you are, the wideness of expanded consciousness that you inhabit within your vessel. Something's been highlighted and made very prominent to you throughout this last shift or recently about your multidimensional nature. So this is what this channel reading and message is all about, is going into a bit more detail about how you experience this reality and incarnation in a very multi-dimensional way. Of course, we all are existing in the multiverse of all timelines, right? We're all existing in that multiverse of infinite timelines of potential and alternate realities, except from the majority of people have a singularized perception of this incarnation, meaning they move through their incarnation, perceiving it in a very linear, singularized way. You guys being multidimensional beings means that you're actually aware. You're aware of your multidimensional nature because of the experiences and how you are operating inside your mind and within reality. Because of your awareness to your multidimensional nature, you have certain experiences that others do not, and that can be hard to maybe explain to others if they haven't experienced this. So certain experiences you've had revealing your multidimensional nature has been a process through of awakening, right? This process of awakening has really been you becoming this higher sense of consciousness, of awareness to your untethered multidimensional nature, in a sense of inner connection to your astral space, and your connection to the quantum astral space, in a sense of timelines perception. You do not experience life in a linear, singularized way. I mean, at one level you might, but really This like physical is just one tiny piece of the segment of your reality, because a lot of reality is also happening in the quantum, and you have access to that. So you guys have access to this perception of a very vast range and of experiences as you move through life. So you're not experiencing things in a singularized way, you're experiencing things in a sense of tapping into alternate timelines, potential timelines in the quantum realm. And that's what we're really gonna be getting into, okay? So like we say in the multiverse, we're all simultaneously living there in all these different timelines. However, our conscious awareness will inhabit and perceive a one trail or trace of timeline strand. So this was coming through in a sense that, of course, like we just said about the multiverse, having all of these simultaneous timelines occurring, each with different versions of you, different realities, just all slightly different or altering in different ways. However, you know, and in these different timelines of reality, you'll be doing, maybe you have different friendship connections, maybe there's certain relationships that are different, maybe there's certain living locations that are different in these alternate timelines. Maybe you guys, you have access to a myriad of alternate timelines in your perception. So this is what we're saying. We all are simultaneously inhabiting all these different timelines, but you're actually perceiving and have unlocked many of those within your internal self, within your mind, within your third eye vision space, within your intuition, within your feeling, okay? And in this way, you guys actually have access and unlocked multiple higher timelines as well, which means that you guys are in different timelines, maybe have different careers in each one, there's different things you've accomplished in each one, different pursuits you're undergoing in each one, and different lifestyles, but all in this higher timeline way is saying that these are the frequencies of timelines that are currently above the frequency of timeline that you are inhabiting. You have unlocked a myriad and a plethora of higher timelines. And so you guys are always jumping through and traveling through these timelines, but you guys have different envisions too, or different dreams. So because you've unlocked multiple higher timelines, you guys could maybe have altering visions of your dream reality or what you want to manifest, and how, you know, your conscious awareness is perceiving and inhabiting or shifting between these alternate timelines of self as well. And when you go through these deaths and rebirths, as starseeds from isolation back into the 3D and things like this, you're actually shifting your consciousness into a different avatar vessel, into a different self. And this actually reminds me of the reading we did a while back about how you guys, we went into a reading that was about your multidimensional nature and near-death experiences, and how you are maybe tapped into parallel almost universes or timelines of yourself, but not just yourself, your reality too, and how you can also tap into other people's higher timelines and altering timelines as well. And when you meet people, you actually, like, you guys are energy readers, you're seers of your community or of your surroundings or your family. And it's in this very nature, in this very way, because when you are coming across someone, you are actually receiving so much intuitive information about them and their soul at a quantum level, at an energetic level. And these intuitive hits, these are something else that's been becoming very prevalent to you throughout your journey of awakening to your multidimensional nature. Like, this is very intertwined within that, is that you've become very aware of your intuitive hits and energy perceptions of others upon meeting. You know, you see others' higher timelines and you have access to them because you almost can I want to say inspire, but that it's like you have access to them because when you bounce in conversation, you awaken these places and pieces inside of other people. You show them alternate timeline paths, either through yourself or through what you're tapping into of them. It's like you also are an energy reader because upon meeting people, you have this like vibe check, like you feel people's energy, you feel people's souls. But the difference is that anyone that you meet, you can feel their energy and their soul self through the layers of the ego. You can see through people's egos and their masks and see straight through to their soul self or their inner child self. Some of you could even see people in your third eye space as an inner child. You could connect to others' higher selves within your third eye space and see them for their soul selves and maybe connect with some of their spirit guides or like pass over loved ones, things like this. You guys are energy readers because you instantaneously are picking up on so much information upon first meeting people, to the point where maybe further back in time, because you're someone who's always been intuitively gifted and always been, you guys were really born this way. And Maybelline, oh, sorry, I'm cracking up now with spirit. Maybe she was born this way. Maybe it was Maybelline. I don't know. Maybe it was Maybelline. I don't know. But you guys, the thing is that throughout this incarnation, you were very heightened and always had this energy perception. Yet it's something that was toned down or tried to be blocked off a bit or suppressed in order to actually be able to function in this society. Because ultimately, empathic and telepathic gifts and energy perceptions, this can be a lot all at once. It's still a lot all at once of information. But when we are actually unaware and we've just incarnated and we have all this amnesia and we don't even know what anything is and what's happening, that is all a lot to have on top of it. So you may have blocked this out throughout certain years, maybe teenager years, things like that, ultimately because it's a lot to deal with, especially if you're surrounded around environments like school environments, work environments, or environments of relationships that were maybe energetically draining or toxic at points. Then it's like almost we protect ourselves, we block ourselves off to protect our energy, right? And you've been reawakening and coming around to this for many, many years again of acknowledging your intuitive perceptions. And something that's very prevalent within you guys in the multidimensional beings community, in our soul tribe community, is that you never suddenly get spiritual gifts or abilities. You just recognize how you're already doing those things. You hone in on them, and once you start recognizing them, they start becoming stronger. And that is what's been happening, is that you've always been empathic, you've always been telepathic, very intuitive and energy readers, and perceiving people for their true soul self and seeing very deep into that, which could be mistaken for everyone just seeing this. A lot of the intuitive information you receive is very obvious to you, and maybe you think it's very obvious to other people, but maybe growing up and going through this journey a bit more, you've realized it's not. It comes very naturally to you, and yet it's not something that's a given per se. So you guys see straight into people's souls. You are, maybe some of you watching are mediums or tarot readers yourself, or this is just something you utilize in order to move through your reality and incarnation for your own self, you know, and checking people's intuition, checking people's intentions, things like that, because you can feel people's soul self and you can feel people's layers of made up masks, and you see straight through them, which is the gift, because normally, you know, the masks that we build up cannot always be seen through by people or others, things like this. You can see other people's subconscious programming. So we went on a whole detour then about that segment, which wasn't even involved in the message, but maybe someone needed that for confirmation. But you know, what we were really talking about is the fact that, yeah, you can perceive other people's timelines, yeah, and your own higher timelines, lower timeline, everything. And why this is relevant right now is that you have been having or about to have heightened experiences showing you your multidimensional nature, because it's almost like it's becoming stronger how It's almost as if sometimes the quantum realms merge with your physical in some ways. Some people watching could have dreams that you have as memories, right? Like you might get a memory and feel it as a memory, but it could actually have just been a dream, right? It can be hard to differentiate when you come to such a level of vividity or lucidity within your perceptions, because ultimately some of you are perceiving snippets or flashes of alternate timelines that feel very, very real, especially because the ones you're tapping into could be very close to the one that you're in right now. For example, you could be having this happen in dreams for you recently when you go to sleep at night. Obviously, let's say you go to bed at 10 o'clock at night, right? There's another reality where you didn't go to bed at 10 o'clock, where you stayed up till 2 o'clock and you met this person and you did this and that, right? Or you did this, like, there's all these alternate timelines. So when you go to sleep in this reality, it's a message coming through about how someone can go to sleep into their dream realm. And whilst your consciousness leaves this timeline and this vessel, you are perceiving your consciousness flick into your alternate timelines and continue, as you know, our consciousness never sleeps. So normally I feel like this is blocked off from people, is that it's normally blocked off to a certain level of this perception, right? This is what I was saying at the beginning about perceiving your reality, or certain people perceive their reality in a very singularized linear way. And so when they go to sleep, maybe they are not having the conscious awareness or perception or memory of where their consciousness is going to after that. You are almost perceiving, or with your higher awareness, having memories and remembering what your soul is doing at a higher level when it is not in this timeline, vessel, or avatar, right? So it's like you're expanded, your perception is expanded beyond this one vessel or incarnation, and you're perceiving reality in a very, very quantum way, which can be very overwhelming at points and confusing at points, because like we're saying, sometimes it can be merged together. For example, if you go to sleep and you hop into another timeline, you could have a dream that felt very, very real, because these are timelines that are very close to you. So you could be hopping into another timeline, maybe having conversations with someone specific, or the thing is, you guys, is that you're connecting with other people's higher selves in these other timelines, and someone that you're connecting with in these other timelines that you could have had a dream about recently is also to a certain level aware as well, in a way that they could remember their dreams or have dreams of you, but they're not adding the things together to be like, oh, this is another timeline. They could just think they're dreaming of you, but they're still having this conscious perception or memory or awareness of their higher self and where it's going, but maybe they are not as sure about what is happening, because maybe this is someone who is not so much into spirituality or opened up to that side of themselves, yet they're spiritually gifted. You guys get guided to a lot of people like this. You guys get guided to a lot of soul tribe or people that you have soul contracts with who are also multidimensional beings. Yet some of these people you're guided to they're not aware that they're multidimensional beings. They're not aware that they're intuitively gifted. They're not maybe fully awakened to their own spiritual nature, yet still having experiences of these things, because like we say, you never just suddenly get spiritual gifts once you awaken. There's something that we realize we've always been doing, but like pinpointing the ways we've been doing that and then deeper recognizing that, honing in on it and expanding and growing that like a muscle, right? But like you're guided to a lot of people who are coming into your path or weaving in and out of your path, who are connecting with you in a very higher self type of way. And there could be someone that you're connecting with right now in a higher self type of way. This could be platonic or romantic. And I'm actually picking up there could be multiple connections of yours, soul tribe, or in this way that you're connecting with a higher self level that maybe you're incarnated with now. Some of them might live far away from you, and some of them might be disconnected from you, yet you have a different type of relationship dynamic in these alternate timelines than you do in this one that we're currently perceiving, okay? So you could be in separation with some of these people could live further away that you're still connected to maybe and talk online, things like this. It really just depends. But you guys, this sense of merging together is confusing because, yeah, these timelines you're tapping into, some of them are very close to you. Some of them are further out, and yet you're aligning with them currently, and they're like dream timelines of manifestations of pure freedom frequency, unconditional love frequency, passion frequency. It's really beautiful to be in the quantum realm and feel through the space, because it's like we're moving through the space in the quantum together, but like through feeling. And you guys could do this too. You can move through the quantum space through feeling, energetically moving, which again can be hard to describe unless you have experienced that within yourself. So let's get back to the message that's coming through. But yeah, you could have been having extra experiences heightened for you in this way of perceiving your multidimensional nature, or it's almost as if you've been granted a wider perception of what your higher self is doing at this time and how you always are connected to it, but it's like being shown to you more, or you're having more memories, or you're having more conscious perception or connection to your higher self right now. And it could be very much to do with the fact you've been through this shift recently that is activating this life force energy and awakening a lot of ancient aspects of yourself and parts of yourself, so into remembrance and things like that. So yeah, again, this is always happening for everyone, existence in all multiverses. However, you are consciously witnessing or perceiving this happening in your physical reality, timeline versions of self, right? So you could be not only tapping into multiverses mentally and astrally, but you could also be very highly aware of your physical self and your physical reality when you are undergoing shifts or have undergone a shift, because you could notice certain things that add up for you in a sense of acknowledging that it's almost as like when you're in a dream, acknowledging you're in a dream, like those steps that lead up to realize we're in a dream. It's almost like that, but in reality with timelines, like you could start noticing little things that feel different, or little differences in your reality or connections with people, shifting of interests, of hobbies, of aesthetics, like interest styles, what you feel drawn to, interest in foods changing, tastes, maybe allergies changing, and routines and surroundings. You're someone who is very highly intelligent when it comes to recognizing patterns and pattern recognition. And so in a timeline, there's a certain pattern that happens of energy, and it creates these routines or habits and things like that, right? And yet when you shift timelines, you notice certain patterns changing within your reality, right? This can be almost thought patterns as well, or cycles, but you guys have this awareness to acknowledgement of knowing when you've shifted because of these little things that you notice that other people do not notice in their reality. So yeah, so not only in your waking, but also in your dreams, what we just talked about, you're splitting off into timeline paths in the astral. And you can do this in your sleep, in your dreams, but you can also do this in your physical reality too. It's almost as if, imagine inside yourself, there's like a screen running, or this feeling of this other space running. And this is also not going to be explainable to people that have not experienced this, which I'm so glad we can connect onto here, because I feel like there's many of you watching who maybe don't have people to connect with, to ask about this in this way, because you are a very, very rare soul and you are incarnated in a specific area and place for a reason. And I don't know, it's just, it's so special. It's so, so, so interesting and special, but I get that it comes with its own pitfalls and struggles and challenges, of course. But you guys, yeah, so it's cool to connect in this way. So you're kind of moving and perceiving this quantum realm in an almost feeling space that's almost set further back within your being. And so when you're in conversations with people, or you're making a decision, right, you enter a choice point, which is where ultimately there's a divergence, there's a splitting of timelines where things are uncertain. So when we come to any decision or things like this, there's a splitting of timelines of potential or variation. I don't know if this is coming through because someone watching has done this, but if anyone's like, what was this? This was in like secondary school or high school, when we first did like IT or tech, and we used to use this thing called Scratch, and it was like you make computer games on it, and to code it in a particular way is like you get to a certain choice point, and then it's like the variables. So you have to be like, this is the choice, these are the variables, and it like starts splitting off. So this is what happens. So when you're like maybe going about and you're like with someone and you're like, oh, should we go out for a meal? Where should we go? There's all these different timelines that then become activated in their potentials. You can access all of those potentials. This might make you an indecisive person because you like to review each timeline or feel or place yourself energetically in each timeline to ultimately see which one's the most optimal or desirable for you before you move forward. So you use your perception of the quantum in a very strategic way, almost like chess, but also let's say you make one decision. So we experience this reality in a very singularized way. This is what we mean. If you go to a restaurant, that choice, you're only ever going to go to one restaurant. But in the quantum, you go to multiple. You go to a plethora of decisions, and you experience this feeling inside of almost being connected to other versions of yourself that did these other things in other timelines. So now we are down this choice point. We've chosen a restaurant. We're going to go there. But now all these running parallel realities are actually occurring, and you could still be tapped into them. So this is just one example. When choice points are there, when timelines divulge or diverge or expand and open up into potentials, this is where you have a very heightened perception of them. And you have a heightened perception, very much so in a quantum way, when it comes to potential timelines, whether that be for the moment, in the moment, or whether that be for near future or very far ahead in the future. And you guys, when we were talking earlier about you having this connection to other people's potential timelines as well, this is also for connections and relationships. So you can perceive or tap into your connection with one person, and you can tap into empathically or are connected to all the other alternate timelines of your connection with that person. And so this can be very, very interesting, being connected to people in this type of way. And also, apart from that too, you can also perceive deeper into others' relationships, whether that be, again, family, platonic, relationship-wise. You can tap into the potential timelines. There is a certain point in timelines where they close out, and there is a certain point, like every timeline has a different length of potential. This is what we're saying. So you can almost energetically fill out relationships, work paths, things like this. And what you're energetically feeling out for in a very subconscious way is the length of potential that that timeline holds, because some timelines are very much longer than others. And so you can feel this in connections, relationships, friendships, and work situations, things like this too. And you may have always felt into this before and knew when certain timelines were coming to an end, certain relationships were coming to an end. You knew that certain relationships wouldn't be forever, maybe from the very beginning, yet had to live out that experience in order to gather what that soul contract was put into place for, right? So it can be actually bittersweet in many, many, many ways. Having this heightened perception of timelines and the quantum and the astral is very, very cool, but all gifts are curses at the same time, you know? And it's like, depends which side we look at it. But at the same time, it can be hard because maybe you've gone into certain relationships knowing they would not be forever, yet you still had to go through and try and ignore that perception and enjoy the process. Same for the opposite. You can feel when relationships are very longevitable, and that's a really beautiful feeling as well. And projects. So there's certain, we talked about this in the last reading, there's certain timelines being pitched to you right now by your spirit guides, and they're very abundant, meaning that the length of these timelines of abundance means that they almost feel never ending with potential. And these are very special timelines. These are higher timelines. There are certain connections and soul tribe incarnated that have come into your life that also have the same energy of abundance in quantum timeline potential. You can't feel the end point. There's so much energy in there, right? Whereas certain timelines have less energy in them, and it's almost as this, like, we can feel it when it starts to get sparse. This is like the same with passions or hobbies or projects, things like this. So you're being pitched certain timelines and having connections come to you who are holding this energy of abundance, and this is that you can feel such a longevity within these, or feel this expansive nature about them that almost carries you through to higher timelines through it or in it, right? So that's very, very interesting. What I found so cool is that we did that reading, was it the day before yesterday, about higher timelines being pitched to you, and that literally is what happened to me that day in a way I've never experienced before. So I really hope that you guys have had your higher timelines pitched to you, and if not, know that that is something culminating and coming for you indefinitely and very soon, is that you are having higher timelines presented to you that you did not have access to before, and you can energetically feel out these timelines and feel the amount of potential in them. And so you can do this for other people too. What we spoke about at the beginning of the reading, about you being this energy reader, this seer for people, seeing their soul self, having access to their Akashic records, I just heard, but that's not what I was gonna say. I was gonna say having access to their quantum reality, which can almost be interesting because it's like a weird thing to think about, having access to someone's quantum realities, even it, like, when they don't have access to it themselves, you know? Like, this is very important. And the thing is that you guys can also sense this in relationships. And I actually got a channeling earlier for you guys coming through that in the Atlantean times, right? This is what it reminded me of, is that there were certain priests, high priestesses, and they would almost examine people's auras or auric fields to see, like, their compatibility when they wanted to, like, have children or maybe marry, things like this, right? There's certain energies coming through in that way. I wonder if we can find that card. Marriage could be something relevant coming through for someone. Guys, it was literally the second card scrolled through. The first one was relaxation, which is beautiful. Find time to rest and relax. Yeah, look at that as well. Telekinesis. Anyway, so the marriage card. So in certain, like, past incarnations, you have been a priest or a priestess that is, like, used or utilized these quantum abilities for other people. And you probably still utilize these in this life, and probably can tell when someone is in, what type of connection someone's in, karmic, soul tribe, soulmate. You can tell and you can feel it, and you might always know, say if your friend's in a relationship, like, if it's gonna last or not. And that's not in a judgmental way at all, and that's not in a way of wanting it to or not. It's simply an energetic observation, and actually there's a lot of empathy behind this, and you might hold a lot of this information to yourself because it's simply not always our place to divulge behind the scenes, you know, but to support people. And the fact is that it's not just about being like, oh, this will last or this won't. It's the reasoning behind it that you have access to, why that connection's here, what they're a reflection of within that person's reality, what subconscious programming materialized that relationship into their life. You can see behind the scenes of people, their lives, what they're literally manifesting for themselves in such a lucid, deeper way. And there could be something about that, because again, a lot of you tuning into these readings are energy readers, whether you practice that in certain ways or whether you just move about your incarnation. It doesn't matter whether you do certain practices or not, like, you have this ability, you always have been using this in different ways of your own. But a lot of people tuning in maybe do read tarot or have maybe callings to maybe write books or to tarot read or create a platform or things like this, right? And so this might be coming through in that way because someone could do like relationship readings or something. That's why this is coming through. Or there could be an emphasis around, I just saw a yin yang. There could be an emphasis around connections right now. That is what we could have been tapping into earlier with the dream state as well. There seems to be a relevance right now in the collective around connections. And how you guys have been through, you guys have been through a lot of purging and clearing out in this last energetic shift. And one of the reasons for that was clearing space for a new timeline. But in that process, you actually healed a lot of old subconscious wounds and programmings. And so you're actually materializing and manifesting a fracture of consciousness, a person who is an evolved frequency that you've healed. And this could be a soulmate or a soul tribe. This could be a co-collaborative energy, a business partner. This could be marriage for some of you. I don't know. This is definitely something really beautiful. If you guys are already married, this it feels like to me someone who you're in a divine union with, or you have very deep past life connections. You see how this angel is in the background for these people? This is angelically guided connections coming into your life. Again, marriage can mean commitment, and that can be business, that can be a responsibility, that can be a pet, that can be anything. It really is expansive and not restricted to just romantic nature and type of things like that. So with this card, it's set. Look, your guidance is to commit yourself to something, a project, your home, family, work, or a relationship. Commitment is a powerful contract that will focus your energy to enable your intent to flourish. You are making commitments, or you're going to be making certain commitments for passions, okay? Whether that be a person, or a pursuit, or a hobby, or a path. Passion is the energy, okay? This marriage is like a yin and yang, a perfect blending of energies, this harmonious blending of energies between you and something else in your external that you're making a commitment to, maybe, or that you will be. So, if a couple wanted to marry in Golden Atlantis, a priest would examine their auras to ascertain that they were spiritually and emotionally compatible. No ring or other symbol was exchanged, for they considered that no one could own or limit another in this plane of free will. Marriage was a sacred lifelong commitment to provide a stable environment for children. They wished to endure. I got shivers then for some reason, so that was obviously a relevant part. There could be a lot of energy being projected through the screen right now as I read this. Again, 44, this number of card is. But this is just what the card and what the card says, so take it as you will, you guys. It's just a bit of information. So they wish to ensure that a child's upbringing was balanced by both masculine and feminine energy in its formative years. Bringing up the future generation was understood to be a great spiritual responsibility. Someone could be, this has come through twice now, someone could be raising indigo children or starseed children, and these are like very highly evolved souls who are coming here. I'm getting big shivers right now. Very, very highly of you're either one of these people. You either are this child, this child of this generation, or you're raising a child of this nature, or both. Okay, of an ascended beings who are incarnating, the same as you guys being star seeds have incarnated onto this earthly plane. There are also other star seeds who have been waiting for the right time to incarnate for the next phase of this earth's ascension, awakening, and integration into new earth. You guys are almost like on the forefront in a sense that things are, you're really kick-starting these things. But as the earth continues and through years and years and years into the future, it will be taken over by higher conscious beings incarnating into this reality. And those conscious higher incarnated beings could be someone like a child of yours right now, or you could be one of these beings, or you could in the future be raising one of these beings, even if you're not really sure. Maybe someone could be adopting, or I don't know, there's just something about that right now. So moving on to the rest of the message, you guys. Let's see. Bear with me, guys. So you are always swinging between alignments to differing higher timelines, which is connected to the shifts in the present. So where we are currently vibrating is going to be matched up with our specific resonant timeline, and that's where we feel aligned. So if you have a particular dream, if you are in a match to the vibration of that reality, you will feel very aligned and on path to trajected to that reality. Ultimately, this can shift and change with our current frequency. So just know as well, if you ever feel out of alignment, it takes one shift in frequency to feel aligned to that timeline again. It is not lost forever, you know, and you're always swinging and coming back around. So there's multiple higher timelines that we spoke about that you have access to that you can shift and swing in between alignments of. So that's very interesting. So you could be shifting and swinging into alignment of a new higher timeline right now. So, but as you ascend, this alignment too evolves, and so does your aligned timeline. So you are evolving, so are your future potentials. Okay, a sense of abundance is really coming through strong in this reading. And not a sense of abundance, the feeling of abundance. Every energy is a feeling of frequency, and you guys feel these energies to a deeper level. So you're actually feeling the emotion of abundance and feeling that in such a way. And that's very, I keep hearing the word prolific today, but you can feel yourself shift between these timelines, and you may even notice the subtle shifts within yourself too, as your consciousness moves between different avatar selves or vessels, physical differences to mental to emotional, like we said earlier, to interests, preferences, and things like that, undescribable tells of yourself in your mind. So you have a deeper or wider perceptional view of the self in a quantum way that may be indescribable to anyone who hasn't experienced these occurrences themselves. Very specific occurrences where in different forms and ways that you have had experiences of a perception beyond the singularized self. You are very much a highly conscious and aware multidimensional soul and being with the conscious awareness of that too. So navigating life has been altered because of this connection to simultaneous alternate timelines. It's almost as if some people, like we say, have this shut off from their perception and experience their path or lifetime in a very linear way, but you are expanding beyond the singularized or linear perception of self. You're expanding past separation. You've expanded past separation to unity consciousness, and you're actually experiencing reality and consciousness of the self and everyone around you being the self. You're experiencing that in an expanded way of unity and perception. So that's very interesting. Surpassing time, surpassing separation, surpassing time, surpassing certain limitations of physics into quantum physics. You are operating from a perception that is not of the 3D plane, that is not of this type of frequency of reality. And so you are actually experiencing reality differently because of that. So this can impose its own complications and challenges in of itself. It's a vast amount of information for the brain to constantly be receiving mentally, but also emotionally. You receive signals of emotions from yourself and others in current altering timelines, but also past and the future. So I get that it can be difficult also to have this physical be so singularized and linear, because there feels inside of you as if there's so much more to the picture or to the picture frame. It's almost what I just saw in my mind's eye then. Imagine like a mural on a wall and you put a picture frame on it, and this picture frame is supposed to be the perception, but you're seeing the whole bigger mural of the whole wall outside of that frame too. Outside of what picture is just in the frame, you're seeing that expanded mural, and that can be a lot. And it's like hard to even fathom how much information your brain and emotion you're tapping into all the time empathically from alternate timelines of yourself and other people, let alone this physical and what you're empathically tapping into, the actual vessels around you here. Like, give yourself credit, you guys, because I feel like starseeds are the ones who are going through so much and having to process and integrate so much mentally, emotionally, you know, going through actual battles and breaking generational cycles and wounds and feeling these entities that you're dissolving within yourself here from the earth. And yet we're the ones who can often be very humble or even too hard on ourselves, okay, or put ourselves down or not quite see our own value, when in reality you guys are such, like, you are beyond belief, you are beyond fathomable, you are beyond comprehension. Your vessel, your soul, your mind, what you're capable of, what you're tapping into, all these things you're doing is awe-striking. It is insane in the membrane to a lot of people, and a lot of people wouldn't even comprehend. So this isn't to put people down or cause more separation. It's just to highlight the fact that really give yourself credit and love and see yourself and feel yourself in the vastness of your power, because I feel like that can even be not wanted to be stepped into sometimes, because a lot of Starseeds can be almost intimidated by their own power. And yeah, that sounds like paradoxical, like, no, like, why would we want that? Why would we do that? But it is actually a real thing I think a lot of Starseeds go through, is feeling intimidated by their own power and their own potential, because there's so much of it, it can become very overwhelming, right? Can be very overwhelming to be tapped into all these timelines and versions of yourself and then have to find a singularized direction between the infinite potentials, right? It's like pick one out of infinity. It's like, that can be hard. So really give yourself credit that you are the person who you are today, and you made it to this place, and all the beautiful connection, like the hearts you've touched, that everything, okay, you are a beautiful, 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 beautiful person and soul, and so beyond your own wildest imagination of who you really are at soul level. So yeah, right, let's see what else we've got here. Two pages left. Oh, this is really long. So this is really heightened recently, especially in dream states. And as I was writing this, the kids were outside and they were talking about Alice in Wonderland all of a sudden. And I was like, wow. So Alice in Wonderland could be a synchronicity or a cat. You guys have cat watchers and one came through as well. And you know, I guess Alice was experiencing the astral and other timelines separate to the 3D physical too. So this multidimensional perception can also sometimes lead to a sense of loss of self at points, especially in these transitions between avatar selves or versions of self. And I feel like that's what you've just been through, is a transition, or that's what you're coming out of, is a transition. So this feeling of loss of self is almost going to be re-solidifying in a clear sense of self again, as you solidify into a affirmed trajectory towards a certain timeline again, because your frequency is solidifying, therefore your timelines are moving from uncertain to certain, are moving from infinite potential to aligned vision in some type of way. So that's where I'm going to leave this reading. I love you all so much, and I will speak to you beautiful souls very, very soon. Mwah. Mwah.